Welcome back to Health Bulletin. Join us for another episode of latest global medical updated on COVID-19. Watch why the World Health Organization upgrade the BA.2.86 variant to a variant of interest. The WHO upgrade BA.2.86 to the status of a COVID-19 variant of interest due to its increasing prevalence in US cases. Last week, the World Health Organization reclassified the Omicron BA.2.86 variant and its related subvariants, including JN.1, on November 28. As the global situation continues to evolve, even in the United States, where it currently accounts for approximately 9% of circulating viruses, as reported by the CDC today, but not as significant as the Omicron Delta leap. The WHO's Technical Advisory Group on SARS-CoV-2 Evolution initially categorized the highly mutated subvariant BA.2.86 as a variant under monitoring in the middle of August. At the end of October and into the first week of November, BA.2.86 and its related viruses made up 8.9% of global sequences. In its most recent risk assessment, the WHO noted a significant increase from early October when it accounted for just 1.8%. The potential for immune escape by BA.2.86 will differ from one country to another, depending on factors such as the presence of other circulating variants, population immunity, and vaccine coverage. However, it is unlikely to be as dramatic as the emergence of Omicron during the Delta wave, according to the WHO. Research conducted on the blood of individuals who experienced breakthrough Omicron infections, including XBB viruses, indicates strong neutralizing activity against BA.2.86. A promising sign that updated vaccines will provide added protection by expanding B-cell protection. The World Health Organization also noted that T-cell memory is believed to be long-lasting and capable of responding to BA.2.86. Suggesting the possibility of ongoing protection against severe illness. Though BA.2.86 has the potential to cause surges in infections, there's no indication that the disease will be more severe than other variants. So far, there is no sign of a change in clinical presentation, but the experts added that data are currently limited. The public health risk is currently low, and the emergence of BA.2.86 isn't likely to increase the burden on national health systems, the advisors said. The CDC also provides their most recent assessment of BA.2.86. The CDC mentioned that since its initial assessment of BA.2.86 in August, the proportions have gradually increased. Now account for 5% to 15% of circulating viruses, a percentage that will likely grow. In an independent evaluation, the organization concluded that BA.2.86 and its related variants, including JN.1, do not seem to be contributing significantly to the rise in cases and hospitalizations. JN.1 remains below the 1% threshold required by the CDC to be represented separately on its projection graphs, and as a result, it is categorized under the BA.2.86 group. The CDC said it agrees with the WHO's latest risk assessment that the public health risk is low compared to other circulating variants, based on limited available evidence. Meanwhile, a few other variants show rising proportions, the CDC said today. They include HV.1, now at 31.7%, HK.3, JD.1.1, and JG.3. Small increase in U.S. severity marker. In its latest data updates today, which cover the week ending November 18, the CDC reported more rises in its severity indicators, with hospitalizations up 9.7% and deaths up 8.3%. For hospitalizations, a limited number of counties are in the high category, most of them in the Midwest. For deaths, a few states had slightly elevated levels, including Colorado, Kansas, Missouri, and Ohio. Early indicators declined or held mainly stable. Emergency department visits for COVID rose 1.8%. while test positivity declined 1.7% to a national level of 8.2%, higher in the Midwest and Mountain West than in other parts of the country. New Mexico has the highest emergency department visit level, which is only at the moderate category. What is the latest global status? In its latest monthly global COVID situation report, posted on November 24, the WHO said cases declined 13% over the past month. While deaths dropped 72%, though it urged caution in interpreting the trends, due to declines in testing and reporting. The WHO said cases declined 13% over the past month, while deaths dropped 72%. Though it urged caution in interpreting the trends, due to declines in testing and reporting. Test positivity held steady at 8%, with a small drop in early November. There were no major case rises by WHO region, though the African and Eastern Mediterranean regions showed upward trends for deaths. Of countries that regularly report hospital data, hospitalizations for COVID declined 12%, though intensive care unit admissions were up 26%.
Thanks for watching.